Hello everyone. Today we will discuss on Urtica urens, commonly called as stinging nettle. So this is a plant of Urtica. It thrives in nitrogenous rich soil and the whole plant is covered with fine stinging hair. And the reason why this nettle is such an irritant to skin, eye and respiratory system is because of its chemical constituent, that is ammonium bicarbonate. But once the nettle fruit or plant is cooked, the ammonium bicarbonate loses its irritant property. And that's why nettle is also used as nettle tea. And because of its richness in vitamin C, it is one of the anti-scorbutic agent. The main action of urtica urens is on skin, causing burns and urticaria, mucous membrane of genitourinary tract and gastrointestinal system. It acts on the joints, especially causing gout, and also on the glands, mainly mammary glands and thyroid gland. So coming to a very important symptom, it is indicated in the first and second degree burn. So as you can see in the picture, the first degree burn is when only the epidermis is affected, and the second degree burn is when the dermis is also affected. And this condition can be very painful. So urtica, when applied locally or given internally, will prevent the further inflammation, blister formation and scar formation. This symptom has to be differentiated with cantharis as well. So we know there are two types. Okay, one is wet type of burn and another one is dry burn. So wet type of burn is called scald, and dry burn is because of dry heat, like because of a fire or touching in hot iron, and wet heat is because of boiling water or hot oil or hot fumes. So both cantharis and urtica is indicated in burns and scalds. But one important point in cantharis is that it is also a good remedy for sunburns, and the complaints are better by cold application. Coming to the grand symptom of urtica, that is its action on the skin, because of the ill effects of eating shellfish and lobster. Your author also mentions few other things like goat milk and strawberry. Strawberry and other sour fruits, allergy is also seen in oxalic acid. And here there is severe uncomfortable rash, and also it can lead to angioneurotic edema. And one important point is there is numbness and formication on that part. And here the rheumatism, usually it alternates with urticaria. And if you see the picture here, so there is rash and centrally it is white. Around it there is red areola. So this is a picture of the rash of an urtica urens. Okay, and they keep rubbing all the time that part. And that modality of urtica is, it is aggravated by rising from the bed, which is opposite to pulsatilla urticaria, where they have aggravation once they lie on the bed and because of the warmth. And in Epis, the urticaria is fully red looking and burning, and it can be given to either a diffuse rash or small spots. Coming to the gastrointestinal system, here the complaint is also because of skin. So the main complaint is suppression of skin, and that's why there is diarrhea and vomiting. And also a good remedy for splenic affection. And in children, you can think of itching in the anal region because of pinworms or ascariates. Coming to female complaints, there is itching in the vulva, and one more important symptom is diminished milk secretion after parturition. So you can give urtica urines if there is deficient in milk secretion. And in males, there is again itching in the scrotum and rash like eruptions on the private parts. Urtica has a uric acid diathesis, So it is a very good remedy for gout, and it has an action on the joints and also has an action on the kidneys, and it expels the uric acid gravels from the urine. Urtica is indicated in acute attacks of gout. And one more special affinity is the right shoulder or the deltoid, where this uric acid crystals get deposited. Finally, about the potency, locally it is used for the burns, and as a tincture it can be used for skin complaints and acute attacks of gout, and for rest of the complaints you can think of 30 potency. So this was about Urtica urens. Thank you.